How to read a lumbar MRI. The MRI is a specific study used to closely examine various body parts. It will identify findings to your lower back or the so-called lumbar spine. How does an MRI work? Magnetic beams are fired into your body. The magnetism aligns the small particles called protons in parallel. Once the magnetism is removed, the protons scatter back to its normal pattern. To give an example, muscles will scatter protons in a certain direction. Other tissues, such as nerves and ligaments, will scatter protons in different directions. And the firmer and harder tissues, such as cartilages and bones, will scatter them in yet another direction. Scientists have figured out how to measure the scattering, and by doing so, make a three-dimensional reconstruction. MRI studies are excellent tools to view your body parts. Doctors look at MRIs in several different planes. The two main planes are number one, the axial plane, and number two, the sagittal plane. The axial plane is a cross-sectional view from the top of the body. I like to call it the bologna slice view. If you've ever been to the deli counter, the bologna slice is placed into the slicer. This cross-sectional slice is similar to the axial view. As you can see on the screen, these are the axial views of the lumbar spine. Anteriorly, which means the front, there's a vertebral body. Posteriorly, or the rear, there are posterior spinal elements. In the middle is the round space called the spinal canal. Within the spinal canal, we can see individual nerves floating within the spinal sac and the exiting hole for the nerves going down into the legs called the foramen. The sagittal plane is also a cross-sectional view, but that's from the side. The view is about taking thin slices from the side to the middle of the body. In the sagittal side view, the vertebral body is in the front and the posterior spinal processes are in the back. In the center, we see the space, which is a tube of water called the spinal sac. And within the sac, we can see the individual nerves that are extending from the spinal cord. As we go through various slices of the sagittal view, we can also see the foramen. To fast forward your understanding of the relationship between the axial and sagittal views, we'll superimpose the axial views onto the sagittal views and reconstruct the spinal anatomy. By doing this, we've accelerated your understanding of the relationship between the axial and sagittal views, and now you have a much better understanding of the anatomy of the spine, as well as how MRI studies can be used to identify specific parts of your spine. Of course, this is oversimplification of how we read the MRI. Spine specialists spend years learning the nuances of the MRI studies. There are different signaling sequencing parameters that better highlight water content or fat content or inflammatory responses. By merging the sagittal with the axial views, this 3D video clip should fast forward your understanding of how the MRI of the lumbar spine is read. Once we understand what is considered standard anatomy, we can then see the difference between the normal and the abnormal findings, such as disc herniations, spinal stenosis, broken bones, degeneration, tumors, and infections. Thanks for watching.